to see in our courts? If these are the issues, how would you like to see those issues addressed?
So, you know, there's a big move about how we get our judges, whether we're going to elect them or select them. There's a big move for us selecting the judges. While I understand the reasoning behind it, that we want qualified people to serve on the bench, I think it does not take care of the internal and external biases that creep into that process, and how it can leave out people who are entering, you know, the legal system and don't have networks that allow them to be known by people who do this choosing, even though there's a community component. It's a complicated way that's supposed to address all of these issues. However, I think what would be really useful is if we took money out of the judicial elections, meaning we would have a public financing system just for our judges. Since we have trouble doing it for everyone, maybe we can look to do it just for our judges, and then have some kind of criteria that screens them to allow them to run. So it's a hybrid of election and selection. And I would love to see some work done on that. But then the judicial candidate is never beholden to anyone who's, you know, giving them resources to be elected, because that really creates a lot of conflict of interest when you have lawyers who are the biggest donors in judicial elections come in front of you, and how do you, you know, choose to do your, you know, due diligence there. There have been case after case that have shown that somebody puts money on, and then there's an, you know, a verdict given that really benefits that donor. I don't know that how rampant it is, but even one case is one too many. So that's one, if we, how we pick our judges. I would abolish the death penalty. I think that's just wrong. 4.1% of death penalty cases are taking, you know, putting innocent people to death. That's 4 out of 100 people. That's one too many. That is just wrong. We should not be in the business of doing that. We should have a much more robust criminal justice reform system that actually helps whoever committed whatever crime to reform. We are not doing that. We are not adequately doing that. You know, there are all kinds of issues with our incarceration process and what we do to help people remedy themselves. We're really not creating a restorative justice framework at all. So that's one. Another issue, so it's corrupt judges, election versus selection, death penalty, and never having juveniles you know, judged as adults. That is just another, so wrong. I can't tell you how, as a parent, I just think that is just the worst thing we can do to children. And again, research has shown when you do that, when a person who's not an adult is judged as an adult and tried as an adult, they do very poorly. The outcomes of those people are much worse than people who stay in the juvenile justice system. Flawed as it is. So that's another thing that I think we need to change. And then there's the controlling of the bias. I think that is so problematic that it is invasive in all parts of our life, but when you have it in the judicial system, that can really impact you. You can be found guilty of things, and when you're completely innocent because of biases that are present in our judicial system. And a novel way to address that would be, and there's a professor in Drexel who's kind of proposed that in a Brookings Institution report, why not have a virtual system of a judicial system where you don't actually see who the perpetrator is, and so you're not biased by your own implicit biases to assess outcomes for those person. So, I mean, those are things to be explored, but that's an idea I think we should explore much more fully.